Hello students, so last class we discussed the skew lines and distance between the skew lines. Okay, so what are the skew lines? The lines in space which are neither parallel nor intersecting are called as the skew lines. So we have seen the distance between that skew lines. Now what if the lines are intersecting? What if the lines are intersecting or if they are parallel? Can we call them as skew lines? We cannot call them as skew lines if the lines are intersecting or parallel. Okay, so skew lines are the lines which are neither parallel nor intersecting are called as the skew lines. So if they are intersecting, now what will be the shortest distance between these lines? If the lines are intersecting means what is the shortest distance? It is zero. Okay, so lines are intersecting means the distance between the two lines, it will be zero. So here d will be equal to zero. Understand? So lines are intersecting, the shortest distance will be always zero only. Now if the lines are parallel, now what will be the distance between the two lines? Okay, so this is what we are going to study in this session, distance between parallel lines. Now how to identify that the lines are parallel or the lines are skew lines? Okay, so if the lines are parallel, suppose this is L1, this is L2, the lines are parallel means their parallel vectors are also parallel, like B1 bar here, B2 bar here. Lines are parallel means their parallel vectors B1 bar and B2 bar, these are also parallel. So just check that whenever we are writing the equation of lines, are B1 bar, B2 bar parallel or not? If they are parallel, then we can say the lines are parallel. Okay, if they are not parallel, then they may be skew lines, right? So now we'll study how to find the distance between these parallel lines in the space. In 2D we studied, okay, distance between two parallel lines. In straight lines we studied as modulus of c1 minus c2 divided by root of a square plus b square, that is in 2D, but same type formula we are not writing in 3D. Distance between parallel lines. Derivation not required, okay, just observe how we are getting the distance here. Let us take two parallel lines. Let L1 in the form R bar equal to A1 bar plus lambda B bar, and L2 R bar equal to A2 bar plus mu B2 bar. So instead of B2 bar, I will take B bar. B, two parallel lines. And let d be the distance between these two parallel lines. So we are taking the parallel lines L1 and L2. So usually we are writing the two lines means A1 bar plus lambda B1 bar and second line A2 bar plus mu B2 bar. That is what we used to write for two lines. Since the lines are parallel, their parallel vectors are also parallel. Now two vectors are parallel means their drs are proportional. So drs of this vector and drs of this vector are proportional. Now already we are taking the proportionality constant lambda and mu. So that's why I have taken this vector as same, okay, b bar here and here also b bar, okay. So just make sure that the drs of these two vectors must be proportional, the lines to be parallel. Now we are finding the distance between these two parallel lines. Let us see the diagram. Suppose this is a first line L1. Now what is the notation? L1 is r bar equal to a1 bar plus lambda b bar, means it is passing through the point, suppose A with position vector A1 bar, and it is parallel to the vector B bar. Next, take another line parallel to this. Suppose this is the second line, L2. Now it passes through the point B with position vector A2 bar, and it is also parallel to the vector B bar. Okay. Now we need the distance between these two lines. So again, distance, which type of distance we have to take along the line which is perpendicular to both L1 and L2. Okay. So just draw a line like this. So if I am measuring the distance along this line which is perpendicular to both first line as well as the second line, now this distance will be the shortest distance. So whether it is mentioned or not, always we consider the shortest distance only. So this is the distance D, this is point B, suppose this is the point C. Okay. Now here we can join the points A and B. Let us join the points AB, we will get vector AB bar, and BC, now it is forming a right angle triangle. Okay. So I will take angle between this AC and AB as some theta. Okay. Let theta be the angle between AC and AB, AC bar and AB bar, right. Now in this right angle triangle, I will apply sin theta. Okay. So what is from triangle ABC, what is sin theta? Sin theta is opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite is BC magnitude divided by AB magnitude. Sin theta, it is magnitude of BC divided by magnitude of AB. What is magnitude of BC? That is the distance D. So sin theta we can write as, this is D divided by magnitude of AB. What is AB bar here? Since AB bar is OB minus OA, that is A2 minus A1. AB bar is OB minus OA, that is A2 minus A1. So magnitude of AB bar, it is A2 minus A1. So this is sin theta from the right angle triangle. Now also we can find sin theta by using the cross product. Using cross product, what will be the angle between AB bar and AC bar? Using cross product, what is sin theta we can write? It is the angle between this AC bar and AB bar. Okay. So applying sin theta here. So what will be the vectors you can take? It is AB bar cross AC bar divided by magnitude of AB bar into magnitude of AC bar. Okay. Angle between the two vectors AB bar and AC bar. It is magnitude of AB bar cross AC bar divided by magnitude of AB into magnitude of AC. Okay. So what is AB bar here? A2 minus A1 cross AC bar. What is AC bar here? AC bar is in the direction of B bar. Okay. AC bar is in the direction of B bar. So I can take it as B bar only, right? Or you can take lambda B bar. So anyway, that lambda will get cancelled here because denominator we are taking magnitude of AC bar divided by magnitude of AB bar. It is magnitude of A2 minus A1 into magnitude of AC bar, we are taking as magnitude of B bar. This is sin theta. So according to cross product, this is a sin theta value we are getting, and according to right angle triangle, this is sin theta we are getting. So any formula we use, theta is same. Suppose this is equation 2, this is equation 1. From 1 and 2, what we can write? D by magnitude of A2 minus A1 is equal to A2 minus A1 cross B bar divided by magnitude of A2 minus A1 into magnitude of B bar. So magnitude of A2 minus A1 will get cancelled. So therefore, what is the distance D we get? So therefore, D will be A2 minus A1 cross B bar divided by magnitude of B bar. Okay, this is the distance between the parallel lines. Okay, now distance cannot be negative, as distance is not negative. So whatever the value we get here, we'll take a modulus of that value. So D, I can write modulus of A2 minus A1 cross B bar divided by magnitude of B bar. Okay, so we have to take magnitude here. Numerator is magnitude of A2 minus A1 cross B bar. So whatever the value we get, we'll take modulus, so that distance will be always positive. Okay, so this is the formula for finding the distance between parallel lines. Okay, so here we are using the notation B bar, A2 bar, A1 bar. So what are the terms here? A1 bar is position vector of point through which first line is passing. A2 bar is position vector of point through which second line is passing. And what is B bar? It is the parallel vector, okay, which is parallel to both first line as well as the second line. Okay, so this will be the distance between parallel lines. Okay, so try to remember this formula. So this is the theory related to exercise 11.2. So what we discussed here? First we discussed the equation of line in space, that is in two forms we studied, passing through point and parallel to a given vector. Next, equation of line passing through two given points. Okay, so these are the equation of line we studied. Then we studied angle between two lines. Okay, angle between two lines is nothing but the angle between their parallel vectors. Okay, so both in Cartesian form and also in vector form, we studied how to find the angle between two lines. After then, we discussed the skew lines and distance between the skew lines. If the lines are intersecting, distance is zero. If the lines are parallel, this is the formula we have derived, that is the distance between the parallel lines. If they are neither intersecting nor parallel, they are skew lines. And also we know how to find the distance between these skew lines. Okay, so with these concepts, now we can start exercise 11.2 here. See the exercise. Question number 2. Show that the line passing through the points is perpendicular to the line passing through the two more points given. So one line is passing through these two points, another line is passing through these two points. Now we have to prove that these two lines are perpendicular to each other. Okay, so how to prove that lines are perpendicular? Using angle between the two lines. Okay, so already we studied how to take the angle between two lines, both in vector as well as the Cartesian form. So what is the condition that the two lines will be perpendicular in vector form? B1 bar dot B2 bar should be 0, whereas in Cartesian form A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 should be 0 for the lines to be perpendicular. And what is the condition for parallel lines? B1 bar is parallel to B2 bar, there is one condition in vector form. If it is in Cartesian form, the DARs are proportional. A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2. Okay. So, the line is passing through these two points, another line is passing through that two more points. Let us take the given points as, let a line L1 is passing through first two points. I will take it as A1 minus 1 2 and B 3 4 minus 2, and another line L2 is passing through points C 0 3 2 and D 3 5 6. Okay, so using the line joining two points, we can find their DRs. So what are DRs of first line here? DRs of line L1 are, I'll take it as A1 B1 C1. So what are the DRs of line L1? It is passing through two points. Now when a line is passing through two points, we know how to take DRs: x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. So 3 minus 1, 4 minus minus 1, comma -2 -2. So that is 2 5 minus 4. So these are A1 B1 C1. Next, and DRs of line L2 are, I will take A2 B2 C2. So what are the DRs of line L2? It is passing through CD, again passing through two points. We know how to take DRs: 3 minus 0, 5 minus 3, 6 minus 2. So it is 3 2 4, A2 B2 C2. So we know A1 B1 C1, A2 B2 C2. Now what is the condition that two lines will be perpendicular? We have to prove that they are perpendicular. So we know that condition for two lines to be perpendicular in terms of DRs, it is A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 should be 0. So consider A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 is equal to, simplify the value. What is A1 A2? 2 into 3 plus 5 into 2 plus minus 4 into 4. It is 6 plus 10 minus 4 into 4 minus 16, which is 0. So we got the value A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 is 0. Means what? The lines are perpendicular. Okay. As A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 is equal to 0. Therefore, lines L1 and L2 are perpendicular to each other. Understand? This is how we can prove that the lines are perpendicular. Suppose you want to prove that the lines are parallel. How do we prove that lines are parallel? After finding their DRs, see that are the DRs proportional or not. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. If the DRs are proportional, the lines are parallel. If A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 is 0, then the lines are perpendicular. Understand? Right. Let us see the next question. Find the equation of line in vector and Cartesian form that passes through the point with position vector 2i minus j plus 4k and is in the direction of I plus 2j minus k. So we need equation of line in vector and Cartesian form. So in both the forms you have to find the equation of line which is passing through the point with position vector 2i minus j plus 4k. What is this? A bar, position vector of point through which line is passing and is in the direction of this vector b bar. Line is in the direction of this vector means line is parallel to this vector. So that vector I am taking as b bar. Okay. So whenever we need equation of line, so it is in one of the two forms, passing through point and parallel to vector or passing through two given points. So it is which case? The first case, passing through the point with position vector and is parallel to this vector or is in the direction of this vector. Okay. So here I will take a bar, position vector of point through which line is passing. Okay. So here line passes through point A with position vector OA bar is equal to A bar, it is given 2i minus j plus 4k and is in the direction of vector, I will take it as B bar, it is I plus 2j minus k. Okay. So we know A bar and B bar. So what is the equation of line? We know that equation of line passing through point with position vector A bar and parallel to vector B bar is R bar is equal to A bar plus lambda B bar. This is a formula we know. So required equation is R bar equal to A bar we know 2i minus j plus 4k, this is A bar, plus lambda into B bar. B bar is I plus 2j minus k. This is in a vector form. Next, we need equation of line in Cartesian form also. So what is the Cartesian form of line equation? Passing through point and parallel to a vector. Okay. So using this vector form only we can write Cartesian form, or directly if you remember Cartesian form we can use it. Okay. So in Cartesian form, we know that equation of line passing through point A x1, y1, z1, passing through the point A x1, y1, z1 and parallel to vector B bar whose drs are A, B, C is given by, what is the formula we know? Line passing through the point A x1, y1, z1 and is parallel to the vector B bar whose drs are given by A, B, C. What is the line equation? Is x minus x1 by A is equal to y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by c. This is the equation of line. Okay. So here what is x1, y1, z1? A x1, y1, z1 is passing through the point position vector we know means we can write the point, or you know the point means we can write a position vector. So it is point 2 minus 1 4 and what are drs of line, drs of vector b bar, it is 1 2 minus 1. So drs of vector are 1 2 minus 1. So therefore equation of line in Cartesian form is x minus x1 divided by a is equal to y minus y1 divided by b is equal to z minus z1 divided by c. So that is x minus 2 by 1, y plus 1 by 2, z minus 4 by minus 1. This is the equation of line in a Cartesian form. Understanding? So first we are writing in vector form, then we are writing in a Cartesian form, right? Let's see the next question. Question number 6. Find the Cartesian equation of line which passes through the point minus 2, 4, minus 5 and parallel to the line given by x plus 3 by 3 is equal to y minus 4 by 5 is equal to z plus 8 by 6. So we need the Cartesian equation of line which is passing through the point. So line is passing through the point. We know x1, y1, z1, okay, line is passing through this point x1, y1, z1 and the line is parallel to this line, required line is parallel to this line. Now given line, what are drs? 3, 5, 6. So if you know drs of one line, that is 3, 5, 6, what will be the drs of line parallel to this? DRs of line parallel to this, two lines are parallel means their DRs are proportional. So 3, 5, 6 are DRs of one line. What are the DRs of its parallel line we can write? 3 lambda, 5 lambda, 6 lambda, proportional numbers, okay. So proportional numbers are 3 lambda, 5 lambda and 6 lambda. These are the DRs of required line. So once we know DRs of required line and it is passing through the point, now we can write equation of line in a Cartesian form. Okay, so line is passing through point A, it is x1, y1, z1, it is minus 2, 4, minus 5. Okay, line passes through point x1, y1, z1 we know. Next. And the line is parallel to this line, okay, and line is parallel to given line x plus 3 by 3 is equal to y minus 4 by 5 is equal to z plus 8 by 6. Whose DRs are 3, 5, 6. So these are the DRs of given line like this. Suppose this is a required line L, we know it is passing through point A, minus 2, 4, minus 5 and this line is parallel to another line. What are DRs of this line? 3, 5, 6. So once we know DRs of this given line, can we write DRs of required line? What are the DRs here? Proportional numbers. You can write 3 lambda, 5 lambda, 6 lambda. okay, as given line is parallel to required line, as given line is parallel to required line, so drs of required line, drs of required line are, I'll write ABC, that is 3 lambda, 5 lambda, 6 lambda. Okay, drs of required line are ABC, which is 3 lambda, 5 lambda, 6 lambda. Okay, so now equation of required line is x minus x1 by a is equal to y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by c. That is x minus minus 2 divided by a means 3 lambda is equal to y minus 4 by 5 lambda is equal to z minus minus 6 by, sorry, minus 5 by 6 lambda. Okay, so simplifying, x minus of minus 2, x plus 2 by lambda we can cancel, okay, whatever that proportionality constant lambda will get cancelled here, x minus minus 2, x plus 2 by 3 is equal to y minus 4 by 5 is equal to z plus 5 by 6 is equal to some lambda we can write, understand? So this is the equation of required line, understand? So one more point you can observe, this is a parallel line, this is a required line, so what you can observe is their drs, actually we can take same also, actually drs are proportional numbers, but in this case when lines are parallel we can take the drs as equal also, okay, drs as equal also. So two parallel lines directly we can consider their drs as equal, because anyway we are writing the proportionality constant lambda here, okay, so that proportional number it will take care of, okay, so directly we write drs of parallel line also same as drs of the given line, okay. So this type questions are important for 2 marks or 3 marks type questions. Next. See question number 7. The Cartesian equation of line is given, x minus 5 by 3 is equal to y plus 4 by 7 is equal to z minus 6 by 2. Write its vector form. So we should be able to convert, when the line is given in vector form, we should be able to convert to Cartesian form, and when it is given in Cartesian form, we should be able to convert into vector form. Okay, so this practice will be doing more, okay, because sometimes it will be given in vector form, sometimes it will be given in a Cartesian form. So any form given, we should be able to convert to the other form very easily. So line is given, x minus 5 by 3, y plus 4 by 7, z minus 6 by 2. So compare it with the standard form. It is of the form x minus x1 by a, y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by c. So we know what is x1, y1, z1 and what are a, b, c. So using that we can write a vector form, given line x minus 5 by 3 is equal to, we need y minus y1, so y plus 4 I can write as y minus minus 4 by 7 is equal to z minus 6 by 2, okay, given line is of the form x minus x1 by a is equal to y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by c, where what are x1, y1, z1? X1, y1, z1 is 5 minus 4, 6, This is the position vector of point through which line is passing. And what are ABC? It is 3, 7, 2. So what are ABC indicates? These are the DRs of parallel vector. Okay. So here position vector of point. Suppose it is A. So OA bar is equal to A bar can be written as 5i minus 4j plus 6k, and parallel vector. What is parallel vector? B bar I can write. We know DRs of parallel vector. So B bar can be written as 3i plus 7j plus 2k. Understand? Denominator ABC indicates DRs of the parallel vector. In the numerator, x1, y1, z1 indicates the position vector of point through which line is passing. That is A bar. So now equation of line in vector form is r bar is equal to a bar plus lambda b bar. So this is the equation. R bar equal to a bar means 5i minus 4j plus 6k plus lambda into b bar. B bar is 3i plus 7j plus 2k. So this is the equation of line in vector form. Okay. So directly we can write this. For that we should know position vector of point and parallel vector. So position vector of point is nothing but x1, y1, z1 write in vector, and parallel vector is nothing but using DRs of given line. Understand? So we should be able to transform Cartesian to vector form and vector to Cartesian form directly. Okay. Next. See question number 9. Find the vector and Cartesian equation of line that passes through the points. We need a vector and Cartesian form of line which is passing through this two points. So just take the given points as x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2. Let A is a point 3, minus 2, minus 5, and B 3, minus 2, 6. Okay, I'll take the given points as A and B. So what formula we know? We know that vector equation of line passing through two points A and B with the position vectors A bar and B bar is given by R bar is equal to A bar plus lambda into B bar minus A bar. Remember, equation of line we are discussing, okay, in two forms, passing through point and parallel to a vector, then passing through two given points. So here the line is passing through this two given points. So equation of line is R bar equal to A bar plus lambda into B bar minus A bar, where what is A bar here? Position vector of point A, it is 3i minus 2j minus 5k, and B bar is position vector of second point OB bar 3i minus 2j minus 6k. So equation of line is R bar is equal to A bar 3i minus 2j minus 5k plus lambda into B bar minus A bar. Take the difference, 3i minus 2j minus 6k minus A bar is 3i minus 2j
minus 5k. Simplify. R bar is equal to 3i minus 2j minus 5k plus lambda into 3i minus 3i. It will get cancelled. Minus 2j plus 2j. It will get cancelled. Minus 6k plus 5km. It is minus k. So R bar is equal to 3i minus 2j minus 5k minus lambda k. This is the equation of line in vector form. Understand? Next, how do we write equation of line in Cartesian form passing through two given points x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2? Now we write in the Cartesian form. Equation of line passing through two points A x1, y1, z1 and B x2, y2, z2 is, remember, equation of line passing through two given points in Cartesian form is x minus x1 by x2 minus x1 is equal to y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y1 is equal to z minus z1 divided by z2 minus z1, okay, is equal to some constant lambda. So this is the equation of line passing through two given points in Cartesian form. So required line is x minus x1, what is the first point? 3, divided by x2 minus x1, 3 minus 3, y minus minus 2, divided by minus 2 minus of minus 2 is equal to z minus minus 5, divided by minus 6, 6 minus minus 5. Understand? Right. So there is a mistake here. Observe. It is a bar plus lambda into b bar minus a bar. Correct. B bar minus a bar minus 6 minus 5k. Sorry, it is a plus 6. 3i minus 2j plus 6. Correct here. B bar will be 3i plus minus 2j plus 6k. So 3i minus 2j plus 6k means it is plus 5k, it will become 11k. So it is plus lambda into 11k, right? So is equal to some lambda here. So what is the equation? X minus 3 by 0 is equal to y plus 2 by minus 2 plus 2, 0. Z plus 5 by 11 is equal to some lambda. So this will be the equation of required line. Okay. So even though we are getting denominator as 0, don't think that is undefined. Okay. So these are what DRs, we are taking them as proportional numbers. So the proportional numbers may be, sometimes they can be 0 also. Okay. So we will keep it same denominator as 0 only. So this is the equation of line in the Cartesian form. Understand? Two points are given. Now directly we are using that known standard formula in vector form and in a Cartesian form. So using the formula only we are solving here. Understand? Right. So let us stop here. So complete all the problems up to question number 9, so that remaining we can complete in the next class. Okay, thank you.